Excel gives you the ability to actually create your own formulas within the pivot table. There are two ways to do this, something called calculated fields and another called calculated items. Just to explain the difference between fields and items, because it is very important, we need to look at the underlying data. In the underlying data, a field is defined as a column. So for example, the bill is a field. Internet cost is a field, charge to MTN is a field. So if we're going to do a calculated field, what we're asking is to do some sort of calculation to fields. The example I'll show you now, we're going to actually work out what the net profit is, and all we're going to do is take the bill, subtract the charge, subtract other costs to get an answer. This, compared to calculated items, here let's say we've got days of the week, so there's Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, etc. We may want to actually add up items within a field. So for example, I want all the Saturdays and the Sundays to be added up to create a weekend. So the difference between the two is a calculated field, there are distinct columns that we're doing something to, but in calculated item, we're actually working within the field and adding, subtracting, or some sort of calculation to the items in the field. Focusing on the calculated field first, here we have a pivot table, there are dates, we've got the total bill, the costs for the charge, and some other costs. And we'd like to know what the net profit is. In order to do a calculated field, you just click anywhere in the pivot table, you go to your pivot table ribbon, and you'll see over here there's something called formulas. When I click on it, you'll see there's something called calculated fields, and there's the calculated items. At the moment it's grayed out, but again we're focusing on calculated fields. So when I click calculated field, the following appears and it asks you give this field a name. So I'm going to call it net profit, for example, and then you just have to create the formula, and the row labels or the fields are shown here. So we know that the formula is going to be, we want to take the bill, we can either click insert field or double click. We're going to say in this case add the charge because it's a negative number, add the other costs. If I'm happy with that, I could say add and do another one, but for now I'm going to say OK. And you'll see what it has done. It has created a new column. If we look at our fields, you'll see there's another item called net profit. Now in the underlying database, we already had a net profit calculation. I've just shown you how to do it in a calculated field. And if you want, you can do some quick checks. You'll see those add up to 0.09, 0.09. And if we actually pull through the proper net profit field, reformat it, you'll see it gives you the same number. So that's a way to create a calculated field. The benefit of calculated field is if I now go and let's do some sort of a grouping here in months and say OK, the calculated field will continue to do the calculation based on the information it has. Let's just ungroup this. Now let's look at a calculated item. I've created another pivot table here. And what you'll see we have is we've taken the day of the week, which is a field. We've put it into the row label, so we can see there's a 1 represents a Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, etc. And we've got the sum of a bill. What we'd like to do is to add up the Saturday and Sunday to tell us what we do on a weekend. So I know that logically it should come to 267 by adding those up. In order to do a calculated item, the first thing you need to realize is you have to click in the field where the item exists. So if I'm clicked here in a pivot table and I try to do a calculated item, you'll see it's grayed out. You need to click in the field in which the item exists. When I go here, you'll see now you can see something called calculated item. When I click on it, a very similar dialog box appears to calculated formulas. Let's just give it a name. We'll call it weekend total. You'll see the field is already identified as day of the week. And all you need to do is now give it a formula. We get it out of the items. So by clicking on day of the week, it's identified all the unique items. So we're going to say, please add up all the Saturdays and the Sundays. Now before I press OK, just notice this, because this is one of the problems with calculated items. We've already said that that must be about 267 or so. Notice that the grand total is 2237. When I click OK, we now have a new item in the field. It comes to the 267, which is correct. You'll see it adds it up. But you have to be very careful, because what you'll notice is this new total has been included in the items, which means it's affected the grand total. The grand total is now 2505. So this number is now added in which case it means there's some double counting. If you do need to use this, you probably need to get rid of these grand totals. And the way you do it is you can right click on a pivot table and go to the pivot table options and work through some of these items to remove it. To edit or to remove a calculated field or item, again, you click in the field, go to calculated items. To find one that's already been built, you click on the drop down box. You'll find it, click on it. You've got the formula if you need to change it, or if you want to delete it, click delete, say OK, and you'll see you'll be back to the original pivot table.